through all the ingredients we will need for this. We have the marinated chicken, that the recipe of which we went through earlier. This has been marinated overnight. We have the spices we're gonna need. We have the whole spices. We have the cinnamon, the green cardamom pods. We have the cloves or the long. We have haldi. We have chili powder, garam masala, dried fenugreek, that is kasuri methi, salt, dhania powder and jeera powder. Then we have chopped onions, chopped coriander leaves or dhania, chopped methi, cashew paste, ginger garlic paste and chopped tomatoes. And then for the other gravy, we also have petaled onions or diced onions, diced capsicum, chopped ginger and garlic, and we have chili both chopped as well as slit. So we'll start the cooking. We will start with the bhuna masala, tablespoons of vegetable oil. Now we'll add the whole spices, the cinnamon, the cardamom pods. I can smell it now, so I'll go for the next thing, that is cumin seeds or jeera, onions, ginger garlic paste till you put the masala that you have to put. So I'll put 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric, chili powder, coriander powder, lots of it, because that just balances the whole mix, and salt as per taste. Take a smell of the whole mix. Once the rawness of the powder is gone, rawness of the masalas are gone, that means it has cooked. Use a whole tomato. I personally like a lot of spice in my food, so I'm gonna add a bit of green chili. And you cover it and cook and let it cook for a while. So this is a good trick for especially like in a situation like lockdown or even people who are not used to cooking much. Just make this, put it together. This forms a great base for any curry you have to make. So even in the recipe, whatever is the finishing process of the gravy at the end, you can just do that at the end of this itself, and then you have a gravy ready. So let's go back to the bhuna. I think it's already done. Yes, can you see the edges, the bubbling, that's the oil coming up, which means it's already cooked. I am going to take out half of the masala. So now we have the other half. You can keep this for a little bit. It is done. And now to this we add the chicken which has been there in the marinade for overnight. So initially when you're mixing the chicken, mix it in medium to high heat the initial first 3-4 minutes. So the initial cooking of the chicken happens well, and covered. So now it's time to see what's happened with the chicken. It's been around 25 minutes that I kept it to cook. Smells quite good. Okay, now we can cook it on high heat for a little while so that the extra water can just evaporate. Just find out whether the chicken is cooked or not. Just take a knife, just poke into the flesh. Now if it comes out clean and you can feel whether it's soft or hard, you can judge whether the chicken is cooked or not. From here I can feel that it's going in very easily. So looks like it's cooked pretty well. Another gravy left, which I have to add to this dish to make it into a complete dish. But even if you don't do the rest of the procedure, right now what you see in the kadai is itself a dish. All you need to do is just finish it, which I'm going to show you how we can do that. I'm going to just take a pinch of garam masala and add it. Mix it well. Now one thing that we need to have at home is if you want the gravy to be thick, that is, you can have some fresh cream. So if you add a bit of fresh cream to this, then the gravy will just thicken, and you can just garnish it with fresh coriander leaves and can be done with it. You can add some dried kasuri methi leaves as well. So now time to move to the second gravy. I'll just take a bigger kadai. It's easier to take a bigger kadai because once you make the second gravy, I can just add the chicken that was cooked before this into this. So now time to put the first thing again, the cumin seeds. And you can hear the crackle. Favorite things to add in any curry, and that is chopped ginger and chopped garlic. I'm gonna roast it for a while just like that. Okay, I'm gonna add the methi now. Okay, now I'm gonna add the next two ingredients, which is my diced onions and capsicum. Now I'm gonna add some spices, some dhania powder, jeera powder, very little haldi, good chili powder. Remember the half of the bhuna masala that was kept aside, we add that to this. Now comes the magic ingredient, my favorite ingredient in this, and that is the cashew paste. This will add the creaminess, the nuttiness and the richness in the whole dish. Add a bit of water. Not too much, because if you add too much water, the creamy texture will go off. Just scrape the bottom with the water. So time to add the chicken. The masala as much as you can, because that's actually where all the flavors lie. Now it's time to finish the dish. Just finish it with a pinch of garam masala. I'm just gonna garnish it with green coriander leaves. So this is chicken patiala.